A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 24th December, on the front page you have GMM coalition rests Jharkhand. So this is regarding Jharkhand assembly elections results. There are 81 seats in Jharkhand Legislative Assembly, you can see, out of which you can see the Jharkhand Mukti Morcha, Congress and RJD coalition, the three parties together won 47 seats. And Jharkhand Mukti Morcha emerged as the single largest party in the state. But then the single largest party has got 30 seats. BJP got, that is JMM got 30 seats and BJP got 25 seats. It is said while BJP had the highest vote share, means highest number of people voted for BJP, but then that is overall. But in each constituency, it should have maximum voters voting for it. So then only it can win that seat. Otherwise, even if it got good number of voters, it could not win seats. So you can see it led only in 25 seats. It won 25 seats. Then here you have opposition steps up stir against citizenship law. So thousands took to the streets in Bengaluru protesting against Citizenship Amendment Act. The bill has already been passed. It is an act which goes on religious lines. So, protests continue. And below you have Uddhav Jaggan rule out NRC exercise in their states. So these are chief ministers of Maharashtra and Jagan Mohan Reddy, who is the chief minister of Andhra Pradesh. So the two have ruled out NRC exercise in their states and they have assured delegations from Muslim communities that Citizenship Amendment Act and NRC will not be implemented in the states. So it is said chief ministers of 11 states have expressed opposition to NRC. And below you have a sad reality that has long been in existence in Assam. So this is regarding detention centers in Assam. So persons who have been released from detention centers recount the horror in these centers. The Assam has 6 detention centers, you should know. So they are run by Assam's Home Department with approval from Ministry of Home Affairs at the center. It is said these centers have 988 declared foreigners as such. And 935 others had been released after court order. So court had said, Supreme Court had said that if they have completed so much years, they should be left. They cannot be kept in eternity in detention centers. And the government is pending on setting up more detention centers. So an exclusive detention center is being set up in Golpara in a district in Assam, which will hold some 3,000 inmates and will cost 46.51 crores. On page 2, you have 1 crore compensation. NGT refuses relief to UP. So National Green Tribunal has disposed of a review petition filed by Uttar Pradesh government seeking relief from an earlier order in which state government was directed to deposit an environment compensation of 1 crore rupees for failing to curb pollution in Ganga River. So NGT refuses to give any relief to UP. UP has to pay this compensation. On page 4 you have Delhi Cabinet approves electric vehicle policy. 250 charging stations expected. So this is what Delhi government has proposed under the policy. It aims to make electric vehicles 25% of all new vehicles registered in the country by 2024. Registered in the city by 2024. And below you have National Green Tribunal forms panel to look into allegations of constructions on Yamuna riverbed. So this committee will comprise of UP officials and will submit report in a month. On page 8 you have German student who took part in MTCA protests deported. So this is a German student who protested in a rally in Chennai, but he was deported by the government. And this is about migrant workers. Migrant workers taking part in protests were attacked. So these were workers from West Bengal who took part in CA protests in Kerala. On page 9 you have South has higher prevalence of mental disorders. So this is a report which says that 1 in 7 or around 197 million Indians suffer from mental health issues. So this is the data of 2017. So the prevalence of depressive disorders is highest in Tamil Nadu. followed by Kerala, Goa, and Telangana. On the editorial page, the first editorial is Jharkhand Signals. So this is regarding how BJP lost in Jharkhand. So it is said it lost because of its inability to recognize livelihood issues and regional aspirations in Jharkhand. And below you have Brexit on fast track. So Parliament of UK has approved Brexit deal. So UK is set to exit EU on or before Jan 31. And the lead article is Safeguarding Constitutional Morality. So this is regarding post-poll development in Maharashtra, one, and the hastily passed the Citizenship Amendment Act. So it is said this is in conflict with constitutional values. So after the elections, the way BJP tried to get power by imposing president's rule and, you know, claiming majority, being sworn in by the governor and later saying they don't have majority. So this all this goes against constitutional morality. And this is making capital out of political rivalry. So this is regarding Andhra Pradesh. So after 5.5 years of bifurcation of the state of Andhra Pradesh into two new states, Telangana and Andhra Pradesh, the bifurcated Andhra Pradesh, a new capital was proposed for it because Hyderabad falls into Telangana region. So Hyderabad have for first 10 years would be capital for both, but Andhra Pradesh has to form its own capital. So previous government had invested heavily on establishing a new capital in Amravati. But now the new government which has come to power says, that is Jagmohan Reddy government, it says that they will have three capitals rather than one single capital at Amravati. So protests are going on against this. Farmers had given their fertile tracts of land for development of capital at Amravati, and they had also been assured jobs and livelihood. So now with the plan being changed, they would be drastically affected, adversely affected. So that is the problem here. So the present government says we would have three capitals on the lines of South Africa. We'll have a different legislative, executive, and judicial capital. It's called administrative rather than executive, but that's what it is. On op-ed page, you have Periyar, the hero of Vaikom. So this is regarding Vaikom in Kerala, which is where Periyar lived. So on his death anniversary, the leader has been remembered. So you should know about Periyar, A.V. Ramaswamy. So he is metaphor for social justice in the region. So there were scores of satyagrahas which were conducted here. So Vaikom as such earlier was a princely state of Travancore. From history perspective also, you should know about Vaikom Satyagraha, which was conducted here. So you can see here. Periyar handed over temporary charge to Rajaji before reaching Vaikom in 1924. So he presided over the Vaikom Satyagraha. He himself was from Tamil Nadu, but he came to Vaikom in Kerala in support of the Satyagraha. Then this is a decision without forethought. So this is regarding Citizenship Amendment Act. It says government's decision to implement CAA without further forethought, without forethought, has thrown the Northeast into turmoil and shaken investor confidence. And this is a hard Brexit. So this is regarding Brexit. The revised withdrawal agreement bill has been passed by British Parliament, but it has to be approved by European Union too. Britain aims to leave EU by 31st January 2020. So whether it would be hard Brexit is the question put forth. So the important clauses of this withdrawal agreement are being discussed here. Also, you should understand what hard Brexit and soft Brexit means. Hard Brexit basically means, you know, severing all ties as such. And soft Brexit would mean continuing with some provisions under European Union. So that's the difference. Then on international page, you have 5 sentenced to death for killing Khashoggi. So this is regarding Jamal Khashoggi. He was a Saudi journalist who was killed as such in Saudi consulate. So there have been questions raised on how he had been killed. He was killed in Turkey as such, in the consulate of Saudi Arabia. So now five persons have been sentenced to death for the killing of Khashoggi. Three more get jail term, and two senior Saudi figures have been let off. And prosecutor says murder was not premeditated, but the murder did take place. Then below you have Beijing attacks Washington for weaponization of outer space. So China has said that US is turning the space into battlefield, because recently USA announced a new military arm called Space Force. So you have Army, Navy, Air Force, and USA wants to have a Space Force too. So US President Trump has signed 2020 National Defense Authorization Act, which creates this new branch of the US military. So this has been protested against by China. So here you can see Space Force will be the sixth formal force of US military after Army, Air Force, Navy, Marines, and Coast Guard. On business page you have our airlines may fly into $600 million loss. So this is what aviation consultancy firm CAPA says, Center for Asia Pacific Aviation. So carriers have added capacity to capture coveted airport slots owned by Jet, which have led to a drop in fares. But they are suffering losses. This is due to sharp fall in airfares on some of the most profitable routes, because airlines mounted additional capacity to capture coveted airport slots. And below you have power auction cancelled on poor response. So power ministry has scrapped the auction to procure 2,500 megawatts electricity for medium term for 3 years under a scheme to provide relief to thermal power stations, which are in shortage of coal supplies. So this auction did not see good response and had to be cancelled. And this is RBI holds open market operations. So RBI has purchased 10,000 crore worth of long-term government securities and sold 6,825 crores of short-term securities through open market operations. So this simultaneous purchase and sale of government securities was announced by RBI earlier, and it has been undertaken. And this is also Aadhaar to be made mandatory for GST. So this is what has been decided on, that under GST, Aadhaar authentication of physical verification will be made mandatory from 1st Jan 2020. So this is to check and curb malpractices. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asia.com. Thank you.